I have a special treat. We're going to take some communion tonight, and we're just going to bless the Lord and take communion concerning our nation and what we know that God is doing and how he is providing and he is bringing forth justice and righteousness, both of them. And so we're going to pray over America. We're going to take our communion after we do our Bible. So let's get into Proverbs 1 right now for day 1. Day 1, Proverbs 1. Ready? Praise God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you give us a psalm and a proverb every day, that we have a proverb every single day of our month, and that every day we can take a psalm. We can take 5 psalms a day and get through the psalms in 1 month. And as we do Proverbs and Psalms every day, Lord, we thank you that you just enlighten and bring truth, wholeness, and light to us. And we just praise you in Jesus' name and thank you for your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, do you have your Bible? Psalm or Proverb 1, the Proverbs of Solomon, son of King David of Israel. For attaining wisdom, this is what Proverbs is for, David says. It's for attaining wisdom and discipline. It's for understanding words of insight. It's for acquiring a disciplined and prudent life. It's for doing what is right and just and fair. It's for giving prudence to the simple, knowledge and discretion to the young. Let the wise listen and add to their learning, and let the discerning get guidance. For understanding proverbs and parables, the sayings and riddles of the wise. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and discipline. And so that's the purpose and the theme. Now we're going to warning against enticement. Listen, my son, to your father's instruction and do not forsake your mother's teaching. They will be a garland to grace your head and a chain to adorn your neck. My son, if sinners entice you, do not give in to them. If they say, come along with us, let's lie in wait for someone's blood. Let's waylay some harmless soul. Let's swallow them alive like the grave and whole like those who go down to the pit. We will get all sorts of valuable things and will fill our house with plunder. Throw in your lot with us and we will share a common purse. My son, do not go along with them. Do not set foot on their path, for their feet rush into sin. They are swift to shed blood. How useless to spread a net in full view of all the birds. These men lie in wait for their own blood. They waylay only themselves. Such is the end of all who go after ill-gotten gain. It takes away the lives of those who get it. Now warning against rejecting wisdom. Wisdom calls aloud. In the street, she raises her voice in the public square. At the head of the noisy street, she cries out. In the gateway at the city, she makes her speech. How long will you simple ones love your simple ways? How long will your mockers delight in mockery? Fools hating knowledge? If you had responded to my rebuke, I would have poured out my heart to you and made my thoughts known to you. And no one gave heed when I stretched out my hand. Since you ignored all my advice and you would not accept my rebuke, I in turn will laugh at your disaster. I will mock when calamity overtakes you. When calamity overtakes you like a storm, when disaster sweeps over you like a whirlwind, when distress and trouble overwhelm you, then they will call to me, but I will not answer. They will look to me, but will not find me. Since they hated knowledge and did not choose to fear the Lord, since they would not accept my advice and spurned my rebuke, they will eat the fruit of their way and be filled with the fruit of their schemes. For the waywardness of the simple will kill them, and the complacency of fools will destroy them. But whoever listens to me will live in safety and be at ease without fear of harm. And that's it for Proverbs 1. So praise the Lord for this. There's so much in this. There's a purpose for reading the Psalm, the Proverbs, number one, to gain wisdom and understanding and discretion, which we all need discernment right now. Always, but right now is especially the time for discernment. Listening, you know, embracing wisdom, listening to what God is saying in here, the Holy Spirit wisdom is speaking, and to watch and be warned, watching the things that can come at you and pull you down quickly. And then rejecting wisdom, she's saying, you know, you're hating wisdom. Wisdom calls out in the streets. She's saying, come. Come in, you know, she's calling out. Wisdom is here. Simple, simple ones, listen. But then there's mockery and there's, you know, and there's pride and calamity and things that overtake people so they don't listen to the simpleness of the Holy Spirit wisdom. And that is such an important thing because you will be at ease without fear of harm. If you just listen, you will live in safety and be at fear without harm. Do you want that? I do. So you get wisdom. You get wisdom. You get it from the Word, and you get it from communion with the Father. And as you get the word of wisdom in Proverbs, you'll start to commune with the Father as you get in the Word, and He speaks to you. And so whoever listens to me will live in safety and be at ease without fear of harm. So those are the simple things. You won't be destroyed because of foolishness, waywardness, you know, the fruit will show. You'll have fruit that shows, and God will bless you because you are walking with Him. It's simple, it's easy. You just got to get in the Word, listen to what it's saying, and do what it's saying. Let the Holy Spirit wisdom speak to you, and He will help you. He will show you the things. And if you fall down, you just say, Lord, forgive me, and you get right back up. Say, Lord, I want to continue in with you because I know that with you, there's victory. With you, there's life, right? So praise God. And you want to, again, live in safety and be at ease without fear of harm. So get wisdom. So praise God. Now turn to Psalms 1:1-5. We're going to do Psalms 1-5. Praise God. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of mockers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. Meditates day and night on the law of the word, on this law. He is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yield its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does prospers, because you're spending your time meditating on this day and night. Not so the wicked. They are like chaff that the wind blows away. Therefore the wicked will not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish. And I just saw how someone could be sitting there and they could be teaching a person how to do like a skill, like say if it's plumbing or carpentry or hairdressing, and they're learning and they're teaching. But say if that person that's learning is just like thinking about other things, not really into it, gonna just try and do it their way after this teacher gets done talking, well, guess what? They're not gonna get blessed. They're gonna perish. They're not gonna do well with that. They're gonna perish in that. They're not gonna be able to do well with it. But if they're listening to the teacher teach and they're learning, they're going to become a good plumber, a good carpenter, a good hairdresser, because they're listening to the teacher. Well, we need to do that. As we read the word, we're listening to the Holy Spirit, who's our teacher, and He's teaching us things, and it's deep, and we receive it with depth so we can let it go deep inside and take root, and it will grow and become you know, hundredfold return you'll get. So, for the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, okay? But the way of the wicked will perish. Okay, Psalm 2. And he'll help you along if you don't remember how you come back and you just continue to come back and come back and come back until you start noticing you get mature and you get stronger in the Word and in the Lord and in the security of who you are in Him. He wants you to know that. And He wants you to get stronger and stronger. And as you do, then your faith rises and your faith grows. And then you're doing mighty things with the Lord. And you're like, wow, this is so fun. And that's how life with Jesus is fun. So Psalms 2, why do the nations conspire and the people plot in vain? The kings of the earth take their stand and the rulers gather together against the Lord, against His anointed one. Let us break their chains, they say, and throw off their fetters. The one enthroned in heaven laughs. The Lord scoffs at them. Then He rebukes them in His anger and terrifies them in His wrath, saying, I have installed my king on Zion, my holy hill. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. He said to me, you are my son. Today I have become your father. Ask of me, and I will make the nations your inheritance, the ends of the earth your possessions. You will rule them with an iron scepter, and you will dash them to pieces like pottery. Therefore, you kings, be wise. Be warned, you rulers of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest He be angry, and you be destroyed in your way. For His wrath can flare up in a moment. Blessed are all who take refuge in Him. So ask Him for the nations. He can give you the nations. Ask Him for the nations to bless them, to rule them. You know, you will rule them with an iron scepter. You will dash them to pieces like pottery as you ask God for the nations. He will give it to you. You can take authority and pray over the nations and break those spiritual demonic things that are over the nations of the world. And you can set them free by praying over them. And you know, and then they can come to the Lord and find refuge. So Psalms 3, O Lord, how many are my foes? How many rise up against me? Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. But you are a shield around me, O Lord. You bestowed glory on me. You lift up my head. To the Lord I cry, and He answers me from His holy hill. I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear the tens of thousands drawn up against me on every side. Arise, O Lord, deliver me, O my God. Strike all my enemies on the jaw. Break the teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people. So when the enemy comes in, you can say, Lord, take them out, and He will deliver you from your enemies. Blessings, and Lord, blessings be on your people, because you're praying for the people, and you're wanting God to use you. You are His. He is yours. Praise the Lord. And verse chapter 4, answer me when I call to you, O my righteous God. Give me relief from my distress. Be merciful to me and hear my prayer. How long will you turn my glory into shame? How long will you love delusions and seek false gods? Know that the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. The Lord will hear when I call to him. In your anger, do not sin. When you're on your bed, search your hearts and be silent. Offer right sacrifices. Trust in the Lord. Many are asking, who can show us any good? Let the light of your face shine upon us, Lord. You have filled my heart with greater joy than when the grain and new wine abound. I will lie down and sleep in peace, for you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. Praise the Lord. So my heart is to you, Lord. Praise the Lord. My emotions, my thoughts, my motivation, my courage, my action. You are the wellspring of my life, Lord. And then, and when there's anxiety, he is your help. He is your strength. He protects you from the enemy. Psalm 5, give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my sighing. Listen to my cry for help, my King and my God. For to you I pray. In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I lay my request before you and wait in expectation. You are not a God who takes pleasure in evil. With you, the wicked cannot dwell. The arrogant cannot stand in your presence. You hate all who do wrong. You destroy those who tell lies. Bloodthirsty and deceitful men the Lord abhors. But I, by your great mercy, will come into your house. In reverence, I will bow down toward your holy temple. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make straight your way before me. Not a word from their mouth can be trusted. Their heart is filled with destruction. Their throat is an open grave. Their tongue speaks with deceit. Declare them guilty, O God. Let their intrigues be their downfall. Banish them for their many sins, for they have rebelled against you. But let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them ever sing for joy. Spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may rejoice. For surely, O Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with your favor as with a shield. He surrounds us with favor as with a shield. When we're honoring God, for surely the Lord blesses the righteous when we honor him. He surrounds us with favor as with a shield. And all this before it, the prayer of the enemy, it's those who have lied and come against God's godliness and God's people and who have purposed in their hearts to come against God and God's people. Those are the ones that he's talking to here. Let them fall. Let them be no more. You know, strike them down. And it sounds like really strong, but when you get into a point where you see what the world is like right now and the things that are going on, the nations that have come together, the leaders of a lot of these nations have come together to try and bring evil. And American leaders too have done the same. They've worked together. And so God is bringing righteousness and judgment to the nations, to America even. But he's protecting his children, his who love him. So now with that in mind, we're gonna pray. We thank you, Father, for your body that was broken for us. You said, do this in remembrance of you. And as many times as we do, we remember you. And we remember your body broken for us. And you were broken for America. And Lord, it says that when your people pray, that you will hear them and you will heal the land that they're praying for the land. That if my people will pray, I will hear them and I will heal their land. Because the land has to do with our place of occupancy right now. He says, occupy until I come. So we're occupying this land. And you said, if my people come and pray, you will heal their land. You will heal their land. If they come and pray, you will heal their land. Because it's land that you gave us to occupy for now and bring souls to the kingdom. So Lord, we thank you that you push back the enemy. You deal with them like it says in Proverbs 5, that not a word from their mouth can be trusted. Their heart is filled with destruction. Declare them guilty, God. Let their intrigues be their downfall. Banish them for their many sins, for they've rebelled against you, Lord. They've done disgusting things, immortal things, things that are with children and things that have been disgusting. And then with money and with voting and everything, it's all been lies. But we thank you that you're bringing them down, but you're protecting those of your righteous ones, the remnant of God, those that are the remnant of God, you are taking care of. So Lord, we thank you right now that as we take this bread or this body, it was broken for us. You were broken for us so that we could have healing, healing in our land, healing in our bodies, healing in our emotions, healing with our relationships, healing with our finances, healing everywhere with our bodies. He said, broken, I'm broken, so you will be healed. You will be healed and your land will be healed as well. So we thank you and we take. Now we thank you, Lord, for the blood you poured out for us. You said, take and drink. This is my blood poured out for you. Do this in remembrance of me. As many times as you do remember me, your blood was poured out for us, Lord, and we thank you, for your blood washes us clean as snow, washes us pure, and protects and washes and sanctifies and cleanses and purifies. And we love you and we thank you right now. Okay. Remember, your words are your way to victory. Be blessed.